So, hello students, welcome to the part 2 of the photosynthesis. So, in the last lecture, we have discussed about the light reaction and the dark reaction. Okay, in today's lecture, we are going to learn about like how does adaptation in the leaf helps to perform the photosynthesis. So, let's start with the part. First, see, to perform a perfect photosynthesis, we need a large surface area. What does that mean? Suppose this is a leaf. Okay. If the size of the leaf is big, then definitely perfect and more amount of the photosynthesis will be carried. But if the size is too small, then definitely the surface area of the leaf is right now very less. So a lesser amount of the photosynthesis will be done. So there should be a large surface area like this. They say leaf arrangements. Okay, so during daytime, many of the leaf of the plants are exposed to sunlight. Okay, like this, so that this leaf get a lot amount of the sunlight. If this leaf get a lot amount of sunlight, so definitely there would be a chance of more photosynthesis will happen. So during daytime, leaf always forms up a right angle triangle like this. Okay, so in this position, plant absorb a lot of light in this right angle position. Now, third point is about the cuticle and the upper epidermis. Okay, what do you mean by a cuticle? We have done the cuticular transpiration. Okay, this is a cuticle. And what is going to come? It is going to come out here, the palisade. Okay, palisade part. This cuticle, this the above one, should be transparent and waterproof. Okay, means waterproof means from the cuticle the plant should not lose the water. Okay, if the plant will lose the water, so definitely the rate of photosynthesis will decrease. So that is why it should be waterproof, so that it can allow a lot of sunlight. As this cuticle will allow a lot of sunlight to pass in, so definitely there would be a greater chance of the photosynthesis. Numerous stomata. See, if what is stomata? Stomata is the passage or the pores, okay, through where diffusion of the gases takes place, like carbon dioxide moves in and oxygen goes out during a daytime. So if the plants have a numerous stomata, so definitely there would be a rapid exchange of the gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide, and because of this the rate of photosynthesis can occur very fast. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the next point, that is the thinness of leaf. See, what does thinness of leaf mean? If suppose I'm making a thin leaf like this, if the size of the leaf is thin, so what is going to happen? The cell which are present inside this leaf has to travel a short distance. Okay, so it becomes very easy for carbon dioxide to diffuse in, okay, and oxygen to diffuse out. See, we have studied in a cell chapter in the last year that cells helps in the rapid communication part. What does that mean? If the distance is short, the carbon dioxide will diffuse in, okay, and the oxygen will also goes out very fast. So this also is a way to improve the efficiency of the photosynthesis. The chloroplasts. Okay, where is chloroplast located? We have discussed many a time. This is a cuticle part and this is the palisade part. Okay, and there is a epidermis also, but right now I'm not going in detail. This is the palisade mesophyll. What is there inside the palisade mesophyll? There is a organelle, that is a chloroplast. What is the function of this chloroplast? To absorb as much sunlight. Okay, if they will absorb much of the sunlight, so definitely the rate of photosynthesis will be fast. Extensive vein system. Now, what do you mean by veins? You have already heard about this words in the human biology also, veins. Okay, if suppose this is a midrib. Okay, now what I am making is this veins. What is the function of these veins? See, if there would be more veins like this, so what is going to happen? There would be a lot amount of the rapid transport. Okay, see, this leaf is attached to the stem, right? Inside the stem there is a xylem which carries up the water and the minerals. So since it carries up the water and minerals, so definitely it's going to transport to the leaves also. If there are lot of veins inside this leaf, so there would be a rapid transport. Okay, end results of the products of the photosynthesis. So see, when carbon dioxide and water with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll, it gives us glucose, it gives us water, it gives us oxygen. Let's discuss them in detail. This glucose, the formula of glucose is C6H12O6. Okay, this glucose helps the plant to convert its glucose into insoluble starch. Why plants convert their glucose into insoluble starch? Because during night time there is no sunlight. Okay, so there is no sunlight, so that is why the glucose gets converted into the insoluble starch. Okay, then that starch gets converted into sucrose. Also, you have heard sucrose solution, and this sucrose solution is easy to travel inside the leaf during the night time. This is called the translocation of solute. Also, see, what is the work of the glucose? Glucose is a monosaccharide. Monosaccharide means simple sugar. Okay, during night time they convert into insoluble starch for a temporary period. Okay, then this insoluble starch gets converted into sucrose solution, which helps the plant to translocate the food means transport the food to the different parts of the plant. So it becomes very easy. This concept is also called as the translocation of solute. Okay, water. See, the water produced in the process of photosynthesis is very useful also, because this water factors lead to the climatic change also. So this water is very essential for the human life, for the survival. Now, oxygen. Okay, so we know the mechanisms of the plant very well, that they take in carbon dioxide and releases oxygen. Okay, this oxygen helps in the breathing process for the humans and the animals. Okay, so this oxygen is not a waste product. Out of these three, none of the product is wasted, because all of them comes for the daily use. This glucose for the food part, this water for the survival, okay, and this oxygen is also for the humans and the plants for the survival. Okay? Now we are going to learn what are the factors that affect the rate of photosynthesis. There are two types of factors, external factors and internal factors. First, we will understand what do you mean by external factors. External factors are those factors which leads to the environmental part. Okay. Environment plays an important role in this external factors. Okay. Internal factors means inside the plant, inside the leaf. Okay. Now let's discuss this in external part first. Light intensity and carbon dioxide concentration. So let's understand this first point with the help of a diagram. See, this is the x-axis where we have written the light intensity. This is the y-axis where we have written the rate of photosynthesis. Okay. See, what does this shows? When the light intensity is increasing, this is increasing. If this is moving in this direction, it means it is increasing. Okay. If the light intensity is increasing, the rate of photosynthesis also increases up to a certain level. Okay. This level is called the optimum part. This region is called the optimum. But as soon as the rate of photosynthesis increases up to a certain level, then it becomes stable. Okay. So this light intensity and the rate of photosynthesis stops at a particular period of a time, which is called the optimum part, and at the certain period of a level it gets stabilized. Why it gets stabilized? Due to the low level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. If there is a low amount of carbon dioxide in the environment, the rate of photosynthesis will be slow. Okay. But suppose if we increase, okay, suppose if we increase the level of carbon dioxide, so now what happens? See, the light intensity is increasing and the rate of photosynthesis also increases. So till this point it is somewhat at the optimum. Okay, then what happens? It starts to maintain up the stability like this. So what does this shows? That rate of photosynthesis, light intensity, carbon dioxide goes hand in hand. If you increase the level of carbon dioxide, the photosynthesis level will be high. If the rate of carbon dioxide is low, the rate of photosynthesis will be low. Because without the carbon dioxide, plant won't be able to perform the photosynthesis. Now the second part, that is temperature. What does temperature indicate? See, we humans need around 37.6 degrees Celsius inside our human body. Okay, this is the temperature which a human maintains. So same like that, plants also maintain a certain amount of a temperature, that is around 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, it can be up to 40 degrees Celsius also in cactus. Okay, because that plant needs a lot amount of heat. But we are talking in general, okay, what is the optimum amount of temperature? What do you mean by optimum amount of temperature? Optimum amount of temperature means the most suitable temperature. Okay, the most suitable temperature, that is 35 degrees Celsius. So what happens? At this temperature, this 35 degrees Celsius, plants work very efficiently. But what if the temperature increases? What happens? If suppose temperature exceed about 40 degrees Celsius, so at that period of time, the rate of photosynthesis falls. Okay? The rate of photosynthesis falls. Why it falls? The reason behind that. Because at 40 degrees Celsius, the enzymes, okay, the enzymes which are present inside the plant are destroyed. So if the enzymes get destroyed inside the plant, so what is going to happen? See, so definitely there would be the effect of the photosynthesis, there would affect the rate of photosynthesis, and because of this the plants won't survive for a longer period of a time. So the temperature plays an important role. Okay. See, a rise up to 10 degrees Celsius up to the optimum temperature, that is around 35 degrees Celsius, doubles the rate of photosynthesis. What does that mean? See, if the temperature in the start of a day is 20 degrees Celsius, so there would be an increase of 10%, 10 degrees Celsius. So if there is an increase of 10 degrees Celsius, so it will double the rate of photosynthesis. Okay? If suppose there is 25 degrees Celsius, so if we increase it by 10, then it becomes 35 degrees Celsius. So this temperature is best and perfectly suited for double the rate of photosynthesis. Okay? So there should be only increase of 10%, 10 degrees Celsius, sorry. Water content. See, if the water level, if there is a scarcity of water, so definitely if suppose the water level is less, so definitely the absorption level by these roots will be less. And see, if the absorption level will be less, so definitely there will be a loss in transpiration rate also. If water will transpire less, the rate of photosynthesis will also decreases. So definitely it depends on the water level also. So that is why we always heard about this, that you should water a plant twice a day, because plants need a lot amount of water. If we water it very well, if we pot a plant and we water it daily, so definitely the plant will be strong. So same like that, if the water level decreases, the rate of photosynthesis also decreases. So this was all about the external factors. Now we are going to talk about the internal factors, that is chlorophyll, protoplasm, structure of leaf. Now let's understand chlorophyll. What is the work of the chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is a pigment, okay, that imparts green color to the plants. It's a pigment, okay? Pigments, what do you mean by pigments? Which imparts color. If there is any nutritional deficiency, so definitely the level of the chlorophyll will decrease. If the level of the chlorophyll will decrease, so definitely it won't be able to trap a lot of solar energy. Okay, if there is any problem in the chlorophyll, the rate of trapping of solar energy will also decrease. So what is going to happen? The rate of photosynthesis will decrease, because we know this part very well, that we need a more amount of a sunlight so that plants work in an efficient way. Protoplasm. What is a protoplasm? See, suppose it's a nuclear membrane. ओके, दिस इज अ सेल वॉल, सेल मेम्ब्रेन. इनसाइड दिस, दिस इज अ न्यूक्लियस एंड दिस एम्प्टी स्पेस इज कॉल्ड साइटोप्लाज्म. दिस इज अ साइटोप्लाज्म एंड दिस इज अ न्यूक्लियस. दिस न्यूक्लियस एंड साइटोप्लाज्म आर टुगेदर कॉल्ड प्रोटोप्लाज्म. वाई दे आर कॉल्ड प्रोटोप्लाज्म? बिकॉज दे आर द लिविंग पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट्स. बिकॉज दिस न्यूक्लियस एंड साइटोप्लाज्म कंबाइन टू फॉर्म अ प्रोटोप्लाज्म एंड दिस इज अ लिविंग पार्ट. इफ सपोज देर इज अ डिहाइड्रेशन इन द प्रोटोप्लाज्म, वॉट डू मीन बाई डिहाइड्रेशन? द वॉटर लेवल डिक्रीजेस. इन विच द वॉटर लेवल डिक्रीजेस. इफ द वॉटर लेवल डिक्रीजेस मीन्स देर इज अ डिहाइड्रेशन ऑफ प्रोटोप्लाज्म, तो डेफिनेटली इट वोंट बी एबल टू परफॉर्म ऑफ द फोटोसिंथेसिस. एज इट वोंट बी एबल टू परफॉर्म द फोटोसिंथेसिस, सो वॉट इज गोइंग टू हैपन? The level of carbohydrates, that is the food, will also go down and the plants can die very fast. Now the structures of leaf. Structure of leaf. The thickness of cuticle. Okay. See, we have already studied in the adaptation plan that the cuticle should be transparent and waterproof. If suppose, assume that this cuticle part is very thick in nature, okay, not thinner, thick, so what is going to happen? It won't be able to absorb as much sunlight. If it won't be able to absorb the sunlight, so what is going to happen? The plant will die. So there was a point that the cuticle should be not that thick also, it should be transparent so that it can absorb a lot amount of sunlight. Now photosynthesis at night. Photosynthesis occurs during the night time also, okay, but this photosynthesis are for some specific plants only. That is tulsi, neem, peepal, etc. Because what happens, this tulsi, neem, peepal, and even cactus also, you can take it as an example. What happens? See, let's talk some desert plant, that is cactus. So what happens in a cactus? See, we know that there is a lot amount of sunlight in the desert areas. Okay, desert areas. So this cactus get a lot amount of a sunlight. So what is going to happen if this cactus absorb a lot amount of a sunlight? It will transpire more, okay, the rate of transpiration will increase in these plants, and definitely no plant will be able to survive in this condition, this hot region. So what does this cactus, so how does this cactus work during a daytime? This cactus work during a daytime. During daytime, the stomatas which are present in the cactus close, okay, exactly reverse. Stomata is close. So definitely there won't be there won't be any diffusion of gases that takes place during the daytime. And during night time, when the temperature falls, the stomata opens, okay, so they are able to release up the oxygen during a night time also, so which helps these desert plants to make up their food during a night time, and this process is called a camp pathway. Camp pathway, because this is a something very peculiar about these plants. During daytime the stomata is closed, and during nighttime the stomata is open, which helps to make which helps them to perform the photosynthesis during a nighttime also. Okay, now experiment time. So we have studied about the photosynthesis, the different process and all. Now we are going to learn about the experiment. So there is a first concept you should understand it perfectly, because a lot of question has been asked from this part only. Destarching of leaf. Destarch. That is removal of starch. What do you mean by starch? It's an type of carbohydrate which is insoluble in nature. Okay, which is insoluble in nature, which plants store during a night time. Now what is a destarch leaf? A destarch leaf is one which is free from the starch. Okay, there won't be any presence of a starch. Okay, there won't be presence of any food in easier sense inside the plant. So what happens to this kind of a plants? How we will come to know? Let's understand with some examples. First, how to destarch the leaf? Let's understand this process. So for destarch, we should take a plant, okay, and we should keep in dark for around 24 to 48 hours. Okay, take a plant, keep in a dark room. Okay, keep that plant in a dark room where there is no presence of sunlight. Okay, so what is going to happen? Let's see. Keep up to this hour, so there would be a removal of starch. Now we are going to see okay, whether when we kept the plant for 24 to 48 hours, at that period of a time, does the plant have lose the starch or not? Let's understand. What you have to do? You have to take a leaf. Okay. You have to take a leaf of that. You have to keep that leaf in a boiling water for around 30 seconds. Why we should keep the leaf for 30 seconds? First, the answer for this is because in this 30 seconds, the cells which are present inside the leaf will be killed. Okay, the cells which are present inside this leaf will be killed if we boil this leaf for 30 seconds. Then second part, so the cells are dead. Second part, boil leaf in alcohol. See, we have to take a test tube. Inside a test tube, we should fill it with the alcohol, and inside that you have to keep a leaf. Okay. See here in the diagram, you can see this part, and you should keep this test tube in a beaker, and the beaker should be full of water. Now we have to boil, right? To boil means you need a burner also. So what is going to happen? What is the function of this alcohol? This alcohol means methylated spirit. Okay, methylated spirit. The word is very specific. You should mention this word. That is methylated spirit. This methylated spirit, what is going to happen? If we put the leaf in the methylated spirit, so it will become pale. Okay, it will start to lose the color, and due to which the chlorophyll will be removed. What we will remove? There would be a removal of chlorophyll. So what is the function of this alcohol? For the removal of chlorophyll. Okay, so in the step 2, what happens after boiling? When we saw the leaf, it was hard and brittle. What do you mean by brittle? That can be easily broken down. Okay, that can be easily broken down like a chalk. If you apply the force on the chalk, so it gets broken down. So brittle means it can be easily broken down. Okay, so what we should do again in the third step, we should dip the leaf in a boiling water. Why should we dip the leaf in a boiling water? Because it will help to soften the leaf. Okay, the leaf which was hard and brittle becomes soft if we boil it for around 10 to 15 seconds. Now the plant, now the leaf is soft. Now it is not going to break. Okay. Now in the fourth step, we have to see. See, in the first step, what we did, we killed the cell. In the second step, what we did, we have removed the chlorophyll. In the fourth step, what we did, we have soft the leaf so that it does not break. Now in the fourth step, you have to take that leaf, okay, place it on a white tile and place a iodine solution on it. Okay, see, we can see this tincture of iodine. Okay, we can see this part. We have to pour iodine on it. So what is going to happen if there would be any starch in this leaf, if there would be any starch on that leaf, so it will turn blue black. Okay, if starch is present, so it will turn blue black. But if the starch is removed, so it will turn brown. So remember these two colors, because this is very essential for you. Brown, when the brown color is going to occur? When there will be no starch. Okay, just remember the color. Blue black will indicate the presence of starch. Brown color will indicate that there is no starch. Now this was all about the starch. Okay, so we have performed okay, whether there was a starch or not. Right now we are going to take some experiment and we are going to pour iodine solution in each of the experiment so that we can come to the conclusion whether it is going to turn blue black or not. Now see, you have to take a plant, okay, with variegated leaf. Okay, what do you mean by variegated leaf? See this, suppose this is A. See this A part perfectly. You can see there is some part which is green in color and there is some part which is pale yellow. In the green plant, they have written that the chlorophyll is present out here. In the pale yellow patch, they have written that is, there is a lack of chlorophyll. Now, what are the example of this variegated leaf? That is coleus, croton, geranium, etc. There are many of those. So we are going to just take two example or one example of it. That is coleus, croton, two examples suppose. In this plants you are going to see the variegated leaf where some of the part is green and the some of the part is kind of a yellowish. Now what we are going to do, see, there is a presence of chlorophyll. See this green patch. If there is a green color, so definitely chlorophyll is present. If there is no chlorophyll, so definitely it will turn into pale yellow, right? Okay, this is the start of the experiment. Okay, the original color is this only. Now what we are going to do, we are going to take this leaf, this A1 leaf, and we are going to destarch the leaf. How to destarch? Keep the potted plant in a dark room for 48 hours. Okay, 24 to 48 hours. Okay, now when you destarch the leaf, place that plant again in the sun. Okay, after few hours, pluck one leaf of this, one leaf, and just see to it that the part which is green in color, that's the middle section of this part. See this part, okay, I'm talking about this part, turns brown. Why it turns brown with the iodine solution? Because I already mentioned, if the starch is present, so definitely it will turn. Sorry. Only the green part will turn bluish. Okay, we can see. Okay, or you can tell brown also. That it shows that there was a presence of this starch. Okay, see, this was a part. This is the chlorophyllase part, which turns blue black with the iodine solution. Why this turns blue black? Because there was a presence of the chlorophyll. See this part, you can compare. There was a green part in the center. Okay, the green part turns blue black. Why it turns blue black? Because there was a presence of a starch. But the part which was non-green, what happens to that part? It turns brown. Okay, it turns brown. What does brown indicate? That there was no starch. So we can conclude from this part, that the chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. If there is no chlorophyll, so definitely no photosynthesis will occur. Okay. Now we have to see whether the sunlight is necessary or not. So take this part, this is the original color, okay, this is the original color of the leaf, and what you have to do, you just have to make a design. So there has been already made a design that is of a green color, okay, that is a green color, and cover this part with the black paper. Why black paper only? Okay, students, see, whenever you perform up any of the experiment, always remember, in the first step you have to destarch the leaf. Okay, we have to plate it with a black paper. So when we pour the iodine solution on this leaf, what is going to happen? See this, the part which is exposed to the sunlight, this star part and the rest of the part, this turns blue black due to the iodine presence. But the part which is not exposed to the sunlight was having a deficiency of this, of the starch, and due to this, there was a color turned brown. Okay, why this appeared to be brown? Because this part was covered with a black paper, okay, so that no light passes on this leaf. Now we have to see, we know that the plants take in carbon dioxide. Now that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. See, there is a twig, okay, which is intact with the plant. See this, intact with the plant. See, one of the leaf, this part, I am exposing with the sunlight, and the second one, I am exposing this with sunlight, but I have kept this in a conical flask, and this conical flask contain potassium hydroxide. What is the formula of potassium hydroxide? KOH. Why it has been placed in the potassium hydroxide? Because the property of KOH, that is potassium hydroxide, is to absorb the carbon dioxide. Okay, is to absorb the carbon dioxide. There is वन ऑल्टरनेटिव क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो आस्क रिलेटेड टू दिस एंड केमिकल अदर देन KOH हु कैन अब्सॉर्ब कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड तो हु इट द ऑल्टरनेटिव ऑप्शन वुड बी NaOH ओके This was one of the question that has been asked in the board paper. What is the alternative way to absorb carbon dioxide if potassium hydroxide is not available? So that is NaOH. So remember this question. So I already said why this KOH was kept so that it absorbs the carbon dioxide. So what happens? See, when leave the plant in sunlight right now, okay, leave the plant in a sunlight only for few hours. After few hours, just try and test the presence of starch. So the thing, this part which was exposed to sunlight, turned blue black because this part of the leaf was getting a proper amount of a sunlight, okay, but the part which was not getting a perfect amount of sunlight, that is this part, turned brown. So why this brown color occurred? Because this part was kept in KOH and this part of the leaf was kept in the sunlight. Okay, so from this we can prove that carbon dioxide, see this part which is green in color was getting sunlight also and carbon dioxide also, but this part of the plant which is bit brown, it was kept in a sunlight, but we have kept this part in the KOH and there was no CO2, so that is why it turns brown. Now fourth, plant takes in carbon dioxide, so what they release oxygen. Now suppose we take a plant that is hydrilla, okay, so where is hydrilla present? It's an aquatic plant, okay, so we are going to get in the water only, okay. Take that leaf and cover them with a short stem funnel, okay, this is a short stem funnel. Now take a test tube and invert full of water. Take a test tube. This is a test tube. Fill it with the water and place it in a inverted position like this. Inverted means like this. Now place this apparatus in the sun for few hours. So we can see that this gas bubbles are arising, okay, this gas bubbles are arising inside this test tube. So what does this reminds of? This reminds of okay, whenever you place any of the plant, okay, so they take in carbon dioxide, so at the same period of a time what they are going to release? They are going to release oxygen. Now if there is really the presence of oxygen inside this test tube, what we should do? We should bring a glowing splinter to this test tube. So we could see that it burst into the flame. Why there was a presence of light inside this test tube? Because there is a property of an oxygen, okay, you are going to learn this in the identification of gases also, If we bring a glowing splint, so definitely it bursts into the flames, which shows the presence of the oxygen, because oxygen supports combustion. Okay, if there is oxygen, bring a flame near it, so it will start to glow. So this was the property of the oxygen. Carbon cycle. Now we have studied about the photosynthesis, all the parts. This carbon cycle is very essential. Okay, this carbon cycle is a series of a chemical reaction. Okay, our 90% out of 100, 90% of the world is made up of the carbon only. That we are going to study in the organic chemistry. Okay, means 90% of the world is made up of this carbon only. So this carbon is very important. Okay, without this carbon, there would be any presence of carbon dioxide. If the carbon dioxide level is not present in the atmosphere, the plants will die. So this carbon plays an important role. See, why this carbon is so important? Because in the process of photosynthesis, green plants, which are called producers, produce their food with the help of carbon dioxide. And from where they get this carbon dioxide? From the atmosphere. Okay, so there are some traces of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere which the plants absorb. So when the plants absorb this carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, they can perform of their photosynthesis. So in this ways, the plants can prepare their own food. So now what happens when the plants produce their own food, which we call them the producers also? Okay, we have studied this in the previous video. Now there would be a link of a food chain. What would be a link of the food chain? Like suppose I'm making a short chain. Okay, I don't have to make this complicated. The plant, who is going to eat this plant? Suppose example, I'm going to give this deer. Who is going to eat deer? Suppose lion or tiger. Okay, let's take a short example to understand. Plant prepare their food. What does this food means? Glucose, na? What is the formula of this glucose? C6H12O6. So there is a presence of this carbon. So this carbon is consumed by this glucose is consumed by this deer. So indirectly this carbon also enters into the body of a deer. Okay, with the help of this carbon, this animals make up their tissues inside the body. This carbon which deer took has been also used by this lion, because lion consumed this deer directly, and deer, the body of the deer was made up of with the tissues, which was the presence of the carbon only. This carbon enters into this lion also. So how the link goes on? See, now respiration. Whenever any of the plants and animal respire, so what they does? The carbohydrates. The carbohydrates means the energy which is present inside the cells, produces energy in the form of ATP and releases carbon dioxide level also. When these plants die, okay, when these plants, animals die, so decomposers feed on them. Who are decomposers? Decomposers are bacteria and fungi which consume up the dead remains of the plants and animals. Dead remains of the plants and animals. In this process, this fungi, bacteria release up carbon dioxide. Okay, when they eat this remains part of plants and animals, so the food that enters into their body, they release in the form of the carbon dioxide. Now let's talk about the combustion part. Combustion means a simple burning. When the plants and animals die, तो दे आर बरीड अंडर द सॉइल एंड आफ्टर मिलियन ऑफ ईयर्स देर इज़ अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सम इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉसिल फील्स. ओके, यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस वर्ड बिफोर ऑल्सो. फॉसिल फील्स दैट इज कोल, पेट्रोल, पेट्रोलियम एंड सी एन जीस. ओके, दिस सी एन जी, दिस पेट्रोलियम, दिस कोल, इट हैज़ बीन फॉर्म बाई द डेड प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स ओनली. ओके, इट नीड अ प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ मिलियन ऑफ ईयर्स. सो वेन एवर वी राइड अप द बाइक तो वी कैन सी दैट ब्लैक कलर स्मोक्स कम्स आउट ऑफ योर बाइक. तो वॉट हैपन्स, what happens, that coal, that sorry, that fuel which is present in your bike has carbon. In the atmosphere there is a presence of oxygen, so this combines to form carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. This is the way also from which the carbon dioxide can be made available in the atmosphere. Now this is very easy. Heating of the limestone. Heating of the limestone means, what is the formula of a limestone? That is CaCO3. Whenever you heat this limestone, so it forms two products, that is calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. See, a large amount of carbon dioxide is released in the burning of the limestone. Okay? And we can see from this diagram also, what does this pink color indicates? This pink color indicates that the carbon dioxide is taken in. What does this yellow color arrow indicate? Arrows indicate that carbon dioxide is released. So just see this diagram perfectly, you will understand this. See, there is a presence of a fossil fuels, root respiration, decay organisms means dead animals, organic animal respiration, automobile factories like brick, heating of a limestone, and this photosynthesis. So this is a perfect carbon cycle you can see in this diagram. Thank you, students. So this was the part 2 of the photosynthesis.